The 10x10 grid represents the unit or one whole. We're asked to shade the grid to represent the given value, write the equivalent fraction for each percent, and the equivalent percent for each fraction. In the first example, we're given 50%. Remember, percent means per 100. So to show 50%, we shade 50 out of the 100 pieces that make up this unit. This model represents 50%. And now we're asked to write the percent as a fraction. Again, because a percent is a number compared to 100, as a fraction, 50% is equal to 50 hundredths. But this fraction does simplify, which means it can represent 1/2 using smaller pieces or smaller parts. If we go back to our model, notice how if we cut the unit into two equally sized parts or pieces, one of the two parts is shaded, which shows 50 hundredths is equal to 1/2. A more traditional way to simplify the fraction would be to divide 50 and 100 by 50. Notice 50 divided by 50 is equal to 1. 100 divided by 50 is equal to 2, giving us the simplified fraction of 1/2. Next, we're asked to model 37%, and therefore we'll shade 37 of the 100 parts that make up the unit. So we'll shade 3 columns and then 7 more small pieces. Here's the model for 37%. As a fraction, 37% equals 37 hundredths. Again, a percent is always a number compared to 100. And this fraction does not simplify. In the next two examples, we're given a fraction. And again, this 10 by 10 grid is our unit or one whole. And because the fraction is 1/4, we want to shade 1/4 of this unit. Because the denominator is 4, we'll divide this into 4 equally sized parts or pieces. And because the fraction is 1/4, we shade one of the 4 equally sized pieces that make up one whole. This is the model for 1/4. And now we're asked to write 1/4 as a percentage. Because this is a 10 by 10 grid, and we can see that 25 of the smaller parts are shaded, this shows that 1/4 is equal to 25 hundredths. 25 hundredths is equal to 25%. So 1/4 as a percentage is equal to 25%. Next, we have the fraction 3/20. Because the denominator is 20, we'll divide the unit into 20 equally sized parts or pieces. And then because the numerator is 3, we will shade 3 of them. Now that we have one unit divided into 20 equally sized parts or pieces, we will shade 3 of them to represent the model 3/20. And now we're asked to write the fraction as a percentage. So beginning with 3/20, if you look at the 100 parts that make up one whole, notice how 15 of them are shaded, which shows 3/20 is equal to 15 hundredths. Notice how we can also obtain this fraction with the denominator of 100 by multiplying the numerator and denominator of 3/20 by 5. Now that we know 3/20 is equal to 15 hundredths, we know 3/20 is equal to 15%. Let's look at two more examples. Here we're given the fraction 5/4. 5/4 means 5 copies of 1/4. Because the denominator is 4, we'll divide each unit, or each 10 by 10 grid, into 4 equal parts, and then shade 5 of them. Notice how because we have more than 4 parts, we know this is equal to more than 1. Now that each unit is divided into 4 equally sized parts or pieces, we know each part is equal to 1/4, and therefore to model 5/4, we'll shade 5 parts. Looking at the model, this also shows us how 5/4 is equal to 1 1/4 as a mixed number. It doesn't ask about this, but this is a nice connection to make. But we are asked to write the fraction as a percentage. Looking at the model, notice how this would be 100%, plus 25%, which equals 125%. We're looking at the fraction 5/4. To create an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 100, notice how we'd have to multiply the numerator and denominator by 25, which does give us 125 hundredths, which equals 125%. Again, we have 100% here, plus 25%, which gives us 125%. Next, we have 150%. Which is equal to 100% plus 50%, So we'll shade 100% of this unit and 50% of this unit. So shading this unit would be 100%. And then shading 50% of this unit will give us a total of 150%. And now we need to write the percent as a fraction. A percent is a number compared to 100, and therefore 150% is equal to 150 hundredths. But if we take a look at the model, and we divide this unit into two equal parts, each part is equal to 1/2, and we have 1, 2, 3 copies of 1/2, which equals 3/2. So this shows the fraction of 150 hundredths simplifies to 3/2. More traditionally, we can simplify this fraction by dividing the numerator and denominator by 50, which is the greatest common factor of 150 and 100. I also want to point out how, as a mixed number, we can see 150% is equal to 1 whole plus 1/2, or 1 1/2. So it asks for the fraction, not the mixed number, but it's also true 150% equals 3/2, which also equals 1 1/2. I hope you found this helpful.